Welcome, dear brothers and sisters, in our Lord Jesus Christ and all who are assisting this sermon. We have arrived at Romans 15. I'm skipping Romans 14, the verses 13 to 23, because I think those need any explanation. The Apostle Paul, in the former verses, is very clear, and here in Romans 15, he repeats again that we must bear the weak. So let me start reading Romans 15. We who are strong ought to bear with the failings of the weak and not to please ourselves. Let each of us please his neighbor for his good, to edify him. For Christ did not please himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of those who reproached thee fell on me. For whatever was written in former days was written for our instruction, that by steadfastness and by the encouragement of the scripture we might hope. May the God of steadfastness and encouragement grant you to live in such harmony with one another, in accord with Christ Jesus, that together you may with one voice glorify the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome one another, therefore, as Christ has welcomed you for the glory of God. For I tell you that Christ became a servant to the circumcised to show God's truthfulness in order to confirm the promises given to the patriarchs and in order that the Gentiles might glorify God for his mercy, as it is written, therefore I will praise thee among the Gentiles and sing to thy name. And again it is said, rejoice, O Gentiles, with his people. And again, praise the Lord, all Gentiles, and let all the people praise him. And further, Isaiah says, the root of Jesse shall come, he who raises to rule the Gentiles. In him shall the Gentiles hope. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound in hope. Today it is the 9th of October. We have the war in Israel, and I will combine these verses with the war. I'm not going to enter into details, because you can see everything on television, on Instagram. We see the horrible pictures of the Jewish women raped, the Palestine dancing on the dead bodies, children in prison, guarded like a dog, and we have those 260 people killed by the Palestinians. But can you blame? Is it the punishment of God? People, those 260 people, they were having a festival of drugs. Possible they even didn't know that they were killed. We must be careful, because God has given Israel to the Jewish people. But the Jewish people, they are completely religious, keeping strictly the Sabbath, but do they honor God? In Israel, the abortion, especially under the girls in the army, is one of the highest in the world. It is allowed that homosexuals can adopt children. Where is the relationship with God? It is all religion. When I was in Israel on the Sabbath, the pedestrian light was red. And the young girls, they crossed over. When they were halfway, also the Orthodox boys, they went behind. And I said, oh, look how it is on summer day. How they respect the Sabbath and God. And they were shocked. And the Orthodox boys, they returned and waited for the green pedestal light. It is all religion. There is no relation with God the Father. So is it in a lot of lives of Christians. They accepted Jesus Christ. They tried to do things, but failing is the relationship with God in Jesus Christ. It is religion, doing things, but not living and doing things in order to please God and to show that they are a Christian. Many are afraid to confess that they are a Christian. They are ashamed for the faith. They keep the mouth shut, like the United Nations. They see all those rapture of Jewish people, all that dancing on the dead bodies, and they don't condemn the terrorists. They keep the mouth shut. And that is the United Nations who must condemn war, who must condemn and bring peace in the world. They are a big shame. Remember that 75 years ago, God started to bring the Jewish people back to Israel. God is giving rain. It is a land full of all richness. The desert is blooming. And still it is religion. There is no grace, real grace, to God. But all the preparations for the third temple are there, the red heifer, the menorah, the altar, the golden vision. The priests are trained. The red heifer is blameless. So it is waiting that something occurs and the third temple will be built. So God, I think, is using this war to bring them to them, to God the Father, to Jesus Christ. In all the past, all those wars, the countries they lost, Israel is promised by God the Father to Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. Not to Israel, not to the Muslims. The Muslims, the Palestinians, they may fight, but they are fighting against God, the powerful God who created the universe. All those stars, all those planets, who created human being. You are fighting against those angels of God. You know you will lose. There's no way you will win. God is fulfilling his promises. He fulfilled after 1,900 years that the Jews returned to Israel. The bones came to life. The Jews are returning to Israel. You are fighting against that God. Oh yes, the Israels. They trusted their intelligence, but they didn't learn their lesson on Sabbat, on Yom Kippur in the past. There were the attacks, and now they were surprised that the angels of God are fighting. Visible, invisible, and sometimes visible. You are fighting as a Palestine, as a Muslim. How could you fight against an angel? Arabia, they might look, fear an attack of Iran, seeing what is going on, because they trust Israel. But Israel, the Jewish, they will not win. It is God who will give the victory. We as Christians, we are incapable to fight against Satan, demons, the fallen angels. But we have hope. Our hope is in Jesus Christ. He conquered Satan. Satan will lose. And all what is going on now, I don't know how far this is a preparation that the third temple will be built in Jerusalem. The two witnesses and the 140,000, they will proclaim the gospel, the kingdom of God, during 3.5 years. There will be another fight, Gog and Magog, and Satan, he will sit in the temple. God will allow it, 3.5 years, and after the 7 years of great tribulation, boom! Jesus is putting down his feet on the Mount of Olives, and all people will see him. All heathens, they will glorify God, praise God. Verse 11, rejoice, O Gentiles, with his people. When Jesus Christ puts his foot on the Mount of Olives, all Gentiles, together with his people, the Jewish, the Israel people, they will rejoice and praise the Lord. There will be the battle of Armageddon, and Satan and all his followers and demons, they will be destroyed and captured. And now we have the war. We strong Christians, 24 hours per day, we are praying for Israel, for the Jews, that God will fight with his angels, that the eyes of the Jewish people might be opened. At the moment, they are our weak brother. But they are our brother in Christ. When Father Abraham, he went in faith to the mountain to sacrifice his son Isaac. At the moment he took his knife to kill his son, God prevented and provided another sacrifice. They say that rock in the golden cupel, in the golden mosque, is there in Jerusalem. There it was the holiest of holies. God will provide the place, will liberate. It are the promises of God. King Salomo, enormous wisdom was given to him, enormous richness. The temple was next to his palace. The majesty of God was there. But he liked women. 1,000 women, virgins, they destroyed him. And God took away the kingdom. He forgot all who had given all that wisdom to him. And how is it in our Christian life of forgetting that Jesus Christ died for our sins on the cross? Are we educating in the churches? Are our church buildings to the honor of God? Or are we full of discontent lamps, full of sins, allowing sins? What's going on? Abortion in Israel. Where is the honor to God? Are we edifying? Are we proclaiming the gospel? Are we living to the honor of God? How is your life? How is your life as a preacher, as a pastor? Do you take care of your weak brothers? Do you teach truly the word of God? Or do you say, that isn't sin? We are called to glorify God. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace, with belief. May the Holy Spirit power you. Live to the honor of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bless you. Give you his peace. Amen.